I'm bad.
Yes, it is. Eh?
Yes, it is.
Thanks for treating me well.
Been blessed.
Me
I got a haircut today.
I see that, Bud. Right.
Can you see the guy?
Can you see your head? Can
you see your name? Smile on
my hand. Let me grab this one.
Oh,
What about heaven? I love that song. I'm gonna come sing with you.
Come on.
Somewhere in the shadows, we'll find.
Save my grace. There is a Thank you.
I'm terrible with names, but you sang a song by yourself.
There's a little black train a-coming, you better get your business right. There's a little black train a-coming, Grandpa?
We can.
Thank you.
That's a good song, Chris.
Well, that's too. I don't need to look for so.
Praise the Lord.
I was thanking the Lord for the opportunity to be back in church.
Amen. It's good to see you,
This is one of Larry's songs, but it's been a request for me, so. Thank you. changed since January 19th of 2006, but I'm thankful for what my grandpa did teach me.
Amen.
That's
my birthday.
Birthday. Yeah. Grandpa was a farmer when I was a kid. He never made much money, but he loved what he did. He'd get up in the morning and go milk a cow. He'd get out of his old barn dog because he cooked it really well. He took us to church on Sunday and taught us how to pray.
Come on.
I'll help you from here. No, I'm crippled.
Another one, huh?
We all would.
I don't know the, you go ahead and sing the thing of St. Paul's.
Dennis asked you, y'all, get the same ring. And back to the other one.
I just sung.
Sawbrower.
You think I had another thing song?
That's all you sang where you think she.
I got that on the little card in the middle of it.
Dennis will get. Yeah, we miss Tammy. I do.
I do.
I miss her. It's good to, but I know she's fine. Good Christians too. The smallest, I'll have to find the sign. Lord in heaven above, why'd you pick me to love? Why you love me?
Oh. that, but that's a good song.
How long we got? All day.
We got God's time, not ours.
That's right.
Y'all gonna cut down on one, you need to get this thing done.
Well, thank goodness it's your thing. Well, I guess I'm wrong.
Good to see you this morning, folks. Bonnie was going to come to church today, but she said it's raining. She must be a Baptist.
She don't need to follow again, well, that's for sure.
No, that's true. You right there. You know, it takes a whole river to baptize a Baptist with a drop of rain to keep them out of church.
Well, you got a point.
Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Good to be here this morning. I'm glad to be saved by grace. By grace. What does it say? By grace are you saved through faith, and that none of yourselves is what?
The gift of God.
Gift of God. Who's got a testimony on your heart?
Well, I thank God for saving me for what he's already done.
Amen.
He's a miracle working God. And today's a good day.
It's a beautiful day.
It's a good day for the Lord to come back.
I'm ready.
I'm ready too.
I ain't got nothing at the house I need to go get. God supplies all the needs, and if I want anything, he supplies the strength for me to work for it. God is good. God is good. I'm hunting something. Y'all just speak with yourselves or whatever you want to do. If it's according to the will of God, do what you want to.
I thank the Lord for saving me and all that he's done for me and my family. Keep Otis and Mama in your prayers. Mama was going to come to church this morning, but I guess, like you said, it's raining. But I pray that she gets back in church.
Amen.
I'm going to sing this one one day.
Yeah, you.
Not today.
Y'all can ride together.
I know it.
Y'all can ride together. John chapter 15. We're going to have after service eating today. Whoever's not here this morning. Well, I hope they show up to eat anyway. I hear somebody out there rattling around. Praise the Lord. Abigail.
Yeah.
Remember all the prayer requests, please. I went to see Horton. Yesterday morning, about now, he's stage 5 kidney disease. His kidneys are shutting down. I wish I'd have took a picture of him. He looks like he's lost 10 years. He looks like he lost 10 years. You know, last time I seen him, his face was wrinkled, and he's huffing and puffing. He's laying in the hospital, and ain't a wrinkle on his face. He looks like a young man. I believe he's backing up. Praise the Lord. Talk, that man, he can talk now. Praise the Lord for him. Well, he had to go to dialysis the day before yesterday. He was supposed to go yesterday at 12 o'clock. I got there about 10:15, and the nurse came in to get him. We talked for an hour and a half. I asked him, is there anything between him and God that would deny him access into heaven? He says, I'm all right. Praise the Lord for that. I'm all right. Remember Preacher Bud, he still ain't eating and drinking that in sugar. Remember Yvonne Green, Yvonne Marla, that's his wife. And she's got 2 daughters, Terry and Kim. Remember these also. And many people that's lost. Many people that is lost. Otis Burke, he's hallucinating again. He ain't doing no good. He's in the hospital. Travis said Warren Ellis is doing a lot better. Preacher up here at Pleasant Grove. Is that right, Travis?
Yeah, Pleasant Grove, Terry Reed. People knows it by both names.
Yeah. Remember, Leonard quits. He didn't go hunt next year, and he loves to hunt. But he just didn't feel like it. How old is he, Jamie? 70-something?
I think he'd be 75, 25th of this month.
75, and he still goes out and climb trees? No wonder he don't feel like it.
He's 75 this month. I've got to add it up right.
He got a ladder stand or just a deer stand?
Ladder stand.
He climbs up there at 25 foot.
30.
Mm-hmm. Lord be with him.
He has been with him many years. Pray for him. He's talking about another back surgery. And Truman and his family. Chevy and Kayla. Frank and Pat Watson. Miss Hammock said, remember Casey, she just lost her job. Timmy Hammer, he said he wants to get in church. But he can't get in there right now. I guess he could have chaplain.
They don't have it there.
They don't have it there.
Can't get nobody to come in.
Pray for me too, Trent, and my son and daughter-in-law and her family.
Amen. Okay, my
grandbaby, Lily.
Little Lily. Have you spoiled her?
Yeah, we play music, Christian music, and we'll praise the Lord. She'll
put
her hands up, and yes, it is precious.
Amen.
We're
in a little rehearsal room
this
morning, and Sister Lily was in a revival meeting. I don't know, many years ago, Freedom, and he brought a little young man in a wheelchair. He's all wadded up like that. He was helpless. But the Spirit of God got to moving, and Remember that dance? Jim Rings up there preaching, that little fella, he started getting his hands up like this and raising them up toward the Lord. So you talking about coming undone, coming unlatched. We had us a time. Spirit of the Lord got a hold of that little fella's little crooked hands up there like that. Yeah, I remember them days. But we still serve the same God. People's in good health today and they won't praise the Lord.
Yeah.
Amen?
Yes.
Got good health. Raise their hands just like this. Amen? Still won't praise the Lord. Walk, talk, got good voices, good legs, good feet, shoes on the feet, still sitting like a dead lice is falling off of them. Amen?
Amen.
Can't get them to shut up until they get to church.
Right. They talk about everything but in the church. Talk about the weather, the car, the sorry wife, or husband that they got. Say it again.
Stinking ball game.
I don't care nothing
about the sport. Ball games like this place. Well, we're going to this too. Well, you got out there on that field.
You didn't do nothing. Sat there and cheer him on. And cheer on any kind of ball game, but they can't cheer on Jesus Christ. Amen. Well, through Christ, we have won. And it's a game of life. Through Christ, I have won.
Nothing worth cheering about.
Huh?
That's the only thing worth cheering about.
Amen.
The silence.
Ain't got nothing to say about the Lord. You know, why is people like it? Why are people ashamed of Christ? Oh, I'm afraid I'll offend somebody. No, well, you'll cuss them out. Does that not offend them? Amen. If they make you mad, you'll cuss them out, trying your best to offend them, but you won't offend them with the gospel. Amen? That's the way it is. Well, I'll show him. I'll go over there and pour water in his gay tank. Sugar. Well, you don't think that would offend him? I'll slap him upside the head. That would offend somebody, wouldn't it? Mm-hmm. That don't work too good most of the time.
Yeah, they forget about that, though, in a little while. You offend them with that?
Yeah.
They can't get rid of that.
It leaves a mark, don't it? You offend them with the word of God, it makes them mad down inside. Amen.
I remember my head too. She was telling me yesterday she's talking to God a lot.
Is she?
And they done a video of her in the truck. I guess everybody's seen it where she's got her head nodding and praising God. And
I seen that.
She's,
they was going to church and she was singing right along with them. Praise the Lord. Remember a greater also. He said he'd been talking to the Lord also. Who is it told me that? Brenda said he went in his room a couple weeks ago, went to praying. Angie was going in the shower. She took a shower and came out, and he's still in there praying. His daddy was sitting in there watching. Steve was sitting in there watching the television, and he got up and moved and got over the side as we could hear. Amen. I don't know, he might have stayed in there 45 minutes to an hour praying to the Lord. Can't get people to pray now for 5 minutes. A prayer warrior may be on the way, I hope. Praise the Lord for it.
I asked Brenda to what all of a sudden made a sleeping side start coming to church to her praying and praying. That'll get it done.
That prayer is about something else, man. Praise the Lord.
I watched a movie last night. It's called The Girl That Believes in Miracles.
Yep.
Little bitty girl praying to God and healing people through God. And she would tell them, you know, that's not me.
Yep.
So that's a good movie if you ever get the chance to see it.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Let me ask y'all this question. Why, you know, there's a lot of stuff, a lot of things that we consider the miracles in the Bible. Y'all believe splitting the Red Sea is a miracle?
Oh, yeah.
It ain't with God.
It ain't.
It's not a miracle with Him. Mm-hmm. How about fire falling from heaven and destroying the whole cities? Is that a miracle?
It would be to us.
It ain't with God. raising the dead. That a miracle is to us, not to God. How about one raising his own self back from the dead? All things is possible to God. It's an amazing us. It's a miracle to us, but with God, he speaks and it happens. It's not a miracle with him. It happens. Amen?
We had faith in the mustard seed.
Right. You can say to this sycamine tree, be cast into the depths of the sea. Has anybody got the faith of a mustard seed today? I've prayed a lot of times, and maybe it's just not, people say, well, it's just not time. Maybe I ain't got enough faith. Amen? I'll be honest about it. Maybe I ain't got enough faith. How do you increase your faith, Chris? Stand up and show us. That ain't gonna hurt you. Stand up and show us how you increase your faith. Exercise.
Yeah.
Ain't that right? He did it in Sunday school. He won't do it. He's ashamed of it. You wimp.
Oh, Lord, you embarrassed him.
I don't care. How do you increase your faith? I'm going to tell you something, folks. You ask God, then, Lord, increase my faith. Lord, increase my patience. Increase my long-suffering. My gentleness. My love. You know how all things is increased?
Tested.
Amen. You know what I asked the Lord? Lord, give me this day my provision. Whatever I need. Don't ask for something. You can ask for something specific if you want to. But if it increases your faith, it's going to be tried and tested and put to exercise. It's going to have to be exercised. You're going to have to learn to trust anymore. And the way we learn how to trust is go through something that we need to trust in. That's hard. It might be hard, but since I've been saved by grace, I heard this question on the radio this morning. What would you change in your life if you could go back 20 years? What would you change? Well, I would like to have not so much, not many heartaches and sicknesses. Somebody, a lot of people would say that. I'd like to. Anything that I could change, I would like to have it. It wouldn't be so aggravating and hard at times. Are you sure? Are you sure you'd like to have that? Because what do you do when you get in dire straits? What does a Christian do when they get in trouble?
Pray.
Thank you, Jamie. I wouldn't change nothing. Because when I can't make it, that's when I get on my knees. Amen? When I'm in trouble, that's when I call out to God. What did Paul say? He says, I glory in my infirmities. Amen? He rejoices in the Lord because he's tried and tested. Why? Because he's on his knees and we're calling out to God. He's got closer to God during the infirmities and the trials and the sicknesses and all these things that comes upon him. We call out to God, and that's how we get stronger. Lord, it's going to be good today. Remember the prayer request. Amen? We're going to still be reading in John chapter 15. Let's go to the Lord in prayer. Dear Lord God, our Heavenly Father, I thank you for this blessed day. Thank you, Lord, for every trial, every hill, every desert. Oh Lord, thank you for every swampy, miry mess that I've walked through. Oh Lord God, helps us to learn to trust and obey, for there's no other way to be happy in Jesus but to trust and obey. Lord, whatever we're going through, you said you wouldn't leave us. Whatever fire, just like the three Hebrew children, Lord. Lord, they threw them at the old strong, big soldiers, threw them into the fiery furnace, and the soldiers died. say hallelujah to the land, the only thing that burned up was the restraints that was holding them back. Lord, thank you. Oh, Lord, I love you this morning. And thank you for the prayer request and prayer. The word you tell us, Lord, to call upon you while you can be found and seek you, Lord, while he is near. Lord, you hear this morning, so we're going to call out to you and lift up these requests. Well, I don't know why you're close by, Lord. Heaven, for these are sick and suffering and lost in sin. Sin sick, oh, Lord God. Heavenly Father, let us have the privilege to hear it, that somebody was saved by God's grace, not something that we did. Oh, Lord, I'd like to see people saved. Lord, I'd like to see people come to know Jesus Christ as their Savior. Young Miss Casey, Lord. Oh, Lord God, she needs to be saved with your grace. She needs something to shake her foundation, Lord. And if all of our lost loved ones, the ones who has known the gospel and known the goodness of God and turned back, Lord, we can't do anything for them, but you can, Lord. You can still reach down there below that old miry mess, Lord, and shake their hearts and run your loving finger through their hearts, Lord, and into their minds. And get them to thinking, oh, Lord God, something has got to be done. And Lord, we can't do it, but you can. Lord, the world as a whole has just all but turned their backs on you, Lord. But I thank you, dear Jesus Christ, there is still a stir in your children's heart, Lord. Oh, Lord God, it still causes us, our heart, to skip a beat once in a while. Lord, it causes tears. Our cup flows over at the brim of the cup, which most a lot of times is our eyes, Lord. And Lord, we still feel thy presence down inside of our heart, Lord, in times, Lord. It's no lot stronger than it is in others, but Lord, Jesus, anytime that presence is close by, Lord, that is good for your children, Lord, because we can't make it without you. And you know that. You tell us here in this very same chapter, without me, you can do it, not nothing. We can't do anything without Christ. Lord, we lift up the sick and suffering, ones who's laying in the hospital, ones who's confused, seeing things, oh. Thank you, Lord. When one comes to know Jesus Christ, all voices is put to silence except for the Master, which is Christ Jesus, our Lord. Lord, I thank you for speaking to us through thy word, through the testimony, through the song, through the music, through the preaching. Oh, Lord, thank you, Heavenly Father, that you speak to us through nature. Oh, Lord, we see the glory of the Lord Jesus Christ that you spoke into existence. If we'll just look and see, it's there. If we'll just look for it. Thank you, Lord, for your goodness. Thank you, Lord, for your long-suffering and your gentleness with us, Lord. I understand, Lord, that these fleshly, carnal bodies, these lives, Lord, is just minute compared to eternity. These old fleshly bodies, Lord, that people take so much pride and try to increase, try to make pretty, try to make strong, Lord, is going to all fall away to nothing, and the worms and the maggots is going to feast dearly upon these old bodies, Lord, when they turn back to that dust. But, oh, Lord Jesus Christ, there's a spirit that's been birthed out inside of everyone who's asked for forgiveness, Lord, that's growing stronger, is growing closer. Lord, it's good to know that the Spirit of God
is a great family coming in here. Praise the Lord for you.
Let me go tell them good morning.
We're in John chapter 15. Good chapter, good book. Good morning, Sir Greg. Good to see you, sir. You bring your sack for me?
Yeah.
Hey, Miss Jaden. Good to see you, young lady. Hey, Miss Jennifer. Good to see you, sir. John 15. It's John chapter 15. You know, some people in the church out of today don't like to see cell phones. Amen? But you know what John, Jennifer and Brian doing with theirs? They got the King James Version Bible on there. Amen, Brian. I got it on mine too. Praise the Lord. When I can't get the book and read it, I might even got the audio. I can listen to you too. Praise the Lord. Thank God for cell phones. You can put the King James Bible on. Amen. John 15, verse 16. Listen to that, folks. John 15 and verse 16. Ye have not chosen me. What do you think about that? But I have chosen you and ordain you that ye should go and bring forth fruit, and that your fruit should remain, that whatsoever ye shall ask of the Father in my name, he may give it you. Praise the Lord. These things I command you, that ye love one another. Ain't that good? Today, there's a lot of people in the church houses that think they're doing God a favor for being there. Amen? You believe that? I bet you God's glad he finally got me. Somebody thinks, well, I'm the gift that God was looking for. No. Well, I just decided one day that I would accept Jesus Christ. I'm about to leave that sitting right there and knock it off. I just decided one day to throw in the towel and go with God. You ever heard that? I have. It don't work like that, folks. I didn't choose Christ. You didn't choose Christ. Just so happened by his grace one day, he seen my lost, ungodly, filthy, low-down state come by to check me out. That's what happened. Amen? Ain't that right, did it? He come by my, say it again.
That's a whole lot better.
Amen. I didn't go over there seeking Jesus Christ, but he come over there where I was on that day. Amen? Now, I don't know what that does for you, but it does something for me. You can consider, if I could get that said right, if you would consider the King of Glory, the one that spoke it all into existence and put the seed in itself of the plants, but it's got one that can continue to redo. Paul pointed that out last week. The one that can continue to regenerate all the time. The King of Glory come by where I was lost and in my filthy state. Said, hey, Trent, how you doing? I ain't doing no good at that time, but I am today. Amen. I didn't choose him. He come by my way. So if you think you're a gift, you're something that you're doing God a favor by reading his word or by praying or by having faith in him, bless God, or if you think you're doing God's a great big, what do you call it? A solid. That's what Jimmy, what's her name?
Jimmy Spanker.
Jimmy Curtis.
Jimmy Curtis, he said, man, you done me a solid. You done me a favor. I ain't done God no favor. Amen? He said, you have not chosen me, chosen you and ordained you know you can go to school and get an education and you can get certificates, ordination papers, license, all kind of diplomas and stuff like that. And by according to them papers and these ordination papers and these licenses, messed up, if you read what it says, people say, well, you must know what you're doing. Amen? I don't know what I'm doing. And you can go and study for anything. Josh has got his welders. He's a certified welder. Is that right, Josh? He's a certified welder. He went to school long enough. He took all the classes and he took all the tests. He is a certified welder. He can weld on a pipeline anywhere he wants to in the United States. I don't know if he can weld underwater. He ain't been underwater yet, have you?
I can't swim too good, so that's
not well, I leave you out, Josh. He can go down to NASA and get him a job. He's a certified welder, amen? And that's good. Praise the Lord for it. But you go out here, you can see these people that go to school to learn the ministry, amen? And they'll get their papers, and they'll get their ordinations, and they'll get their license, and they got plaques over there that wide, I mean, that long, telling them all that they have done, all that they have accomplished, all that they have studied, all the books and stuff, and it ain't worth a flip unless God's in it.
Amen. That's right.
It don't make no difference how much I study. Listen to that. He said, you've not chosen me, but I have chosen you and ordained you. Amen. Let me tell you something, folks. I didn't choose to be a preacher. Amen. I didn't want to be a preacher.
But Jesus Christ chose me. And I ain't got all the education, but I've got Christ. Amen. I ain't got all the teaching and the knowledge, bless God, and a lot of things, and I ain't said a thing against it, bless God, but if they ain't been called of God, they're wasting time, and you're wasting time going after it, and there ain't nothing in it, bless God, that's a waste of time to listen to them.
That's right.
Amen!
Amen.
I said. Jesus Christ. You're saved by grace today. You was just like I was. You wasn't looking to be saved. Amen? I wasn't looking for Christ. Matter of fact, I was trying my best to get away from him. Amen? Just to be blunt and honest, I didn't want nothing to do with it. I didn't want to be saved. Amen? But you know what? I'm going to use, Brian, you care about using you for an example. You and Nancy stand up. This is what I'm talking about. Y'all shake hands. Now, this whole room right there just a minute. And this is the way it is to be saved. I'm going to make these two. Now, Brian, you know he's pretty stout.
Oh, yeah.
Now, don't kill her, Brian, but just start putting a little. Nancy, you squeeze all you can. Oh, yeah! Listen!
I'm a tenderoni now.
Squeeze all you can, Nancy. All you can. You ain't gonna hurt him. Now, Brian, just start easing down on the pressure. She'll say, when you say roll, Nancy, he'll stop. Keep.
Whoa.
That's it. See that? That's all. That's thinking. See, Brian's big old stout hand and Nancy's little old bitty. That's the way it is trying to get saved by grace. Amen? Jesus Christ started putting pressure on me, amen? Just like Brian put the pressure on Nancy's hand. If Nancy hadn't hollered, whoa, Brian would have continued, and after a while you heard some snap, snap, crackling, popping going on, amen?
I was scared.
That's the way it is when you continue to reject Christ. He'll put a little more pressure on you. And you continue to reject Christ, he'll put a little more pressure on you. But if you continue, bless God, he'll let off the pressure.
Yep.
That's no good. When people reject Christ long enough, he'll take his hand off of yours, bless God, and you won't feel no tug anymore. That means he has given up. Amen. Now don't get me wrong, Christ don't give up too easy, bless God. If you, let me give you that's a good example. Lord, thank you for reminding. You remember Moses over there? That's a beautiful example. Moses was out there on the backside of the desert, up there next to the mountain of God, tossed aside the eye, and he seen that burning bush up on the side of the mountain. Bless God. And he said, I'm going to turn aside and see this great sight while the bush burned, while the bush is on fire, but yet not burned up. He went up there, and he got up there close to the bush, and he heard a voice, Moses. Glory to God, Moses. And he said, oh, Lord, there's something up here beside the bush. And he said, take your shoes off, Moses, for the ground you're standing on is holy. Amen. Moses had never met God until that day. And God said, Moses, I have chosen. Read that again. You have not chosen me, but I have chosen you. He said, Moses, you're going to Egypt and bring my people out of here. Amen?
Mm-hmm.
Lord, I can't.
Yep.
I can't. Moses was well educated. Y'all believe that? He lived in Egypt for 80 years. Bless God, he was educated for 40 years. He was well educated. He said, Lord, I can't even talk plain. He said, Lord, there's a whole lot more folks more capable than me. That's all kind of excuses. I told you a while ago, God, Christ don't give up too easy, does he? Mm-hmm. Moses, you're going to Egypt. Lord, I can't go to Egypt. He didn't say if you go, Moses. What did he say?
When?
When you go to Egypt, you shall bring my people back to this mountain, and they shall worship me upon this mountain. That's over there in the Old Testament, bless God. Go right read. Go right Exodus, the last part of Genesis and Exodus. That's where it starts at, amen? When you go to Egypt, you're going to bring my people. I can't go, Lord. I can't leave these folks. Amen? He said, I can't talk right. I can't speak. No, you know what? God don't take no excuses. Here comes Aaron. He said, here comes your brother Aaron. I'll send him with you, and he can speak for you. See, Moses couldn't get out of it. Listen, folks, if God has chosen you to do something, you're not going to get out of it. He's not going to give up on you. Moses, he was, I guess he was just a plain old man, which he still was when God got, he still just a plain man, but God didn't give up on Moses. I'll send Aaron. I know he can talk right.
Uh-huh.
Amen. He said, Aaron, we're going your stead. What did Moses go in? Whose stead did Moses go in?
God's.
Say it again, Jamie.
He went
in God's stead. He said, Moses, you're going to be me, and Aaron's going to be you. That's just to put it plain English, amen. Aaron's going to speak what you tell him to, and you're going to show what miracles I work through. Amen? So if you've been chosen of God, amen. Don't think that we're doing a God a favor. I don't think God, Lord, have me say that, please. I ain't got a lick to say it. I don't think that I have done God's service or privileged him with my appearance today in his house. That's not me. I am grateful, bless God, that I had the strength to get my lazy carcass out of bed and my feet should have walked this morning. I had shoes to put on and I had breeches to put on, bless God, and I had the strength to get out of bed and get on my clothes and help Mary Ann get her stuff. She hadn't done it anyway. We all got in the car and we had something to drive here, and I thank God that I had the privilege to be here with you this morning. Glory to God, I love you. Amen. You've not chosen me, but I have chosen you and ordained you. Ordained. There's some more of that. Let me ask you something. Why did God choose Abraham? You got any reason? Did he have any reason? Why did he? Who was the first Israelite? Say it again. Abraham, that's right. Where did he come from?
Ur of the Chaldees.
Amalekites. You know who you know who Abraham was before God chose him?
Our worker.
He's Abraham. I would get that. Ur of the Chaldees, you know where that's at? Babylon. Amen? Over there next to Babylon. Abraham was a Babylonian. His father was a Babylonian. Abraham was the first Jew, the first Israelite to ever. Why? Because God chose him and changed him into one. Abram was a Babylonian. Abraham was his Jewish name. Abram, when he came out of Ur of the Chaldees, he was named Abraham. And his wife's name was Sarai. So when God finally got to the point and chose and got through working, he changed Abram's name to Abraham and Sarai to Sarah. Amen. That's the Jewish name. That's the first two that God that ever walked the face of earth. First two Jews, Abraham and Sarah. God chose them. Was Abraham looking for God? No. I don't think he was. He said, Abram, separate yourself from your family. And he said, I'll show you the road to go. You know, I don't believe God appeared to Abraham in a physical form. But I tell you one thing, if something goes to talking to me and I can't hear it, I'm going to probably pay attention to it, amen? I can't see it. I can hear it, but I can't see it. It's like Paul on the road to Saul on the road to Damascus over there. Bless God. When the light shined, Saul hit the ground and everybody with him. Saul was listening, and so did these other people. They heard the voice, but they didn't see no man. Saul heard the voice, they didn't see no man. And you know what happened? All of them all scared to death. Amen? Amen? If you start hearing voices that coming from the air, I'm not talking about these crazy cockeyed things that people hear today. Hey, people listen to things all the time, hearing voices down inside. I'm talking about the voice of the living God, the Lord Jesus Christ. He said, Miss Hammock or Travis or Dennis, put your name. This is Jesus Christ of Nazareth. I want to talk with you. Bless God, I'll start listening. Glory to God, I want to hear him. And ordain you that ye should go and bring forth fruit. What kind of fruit are we bringing forth? If you are saved by grace, God didn't choose you to settle your carcass and do nothing. Amen? He didn't. Who knows who the secret disciple is in the Bible? There's one. One secret disciple. Anybody know his name? Shame on you. Nicodemus. Amen? He was a Pharisee. he was one of them religious freaks, bless God, that didn't. Nicodemus was the secret disciple. You know why I know that? Because the Bible says he went to Christ at night and conversed with him. Amen? Why did he go at night? Because he's scared to death of them other folks too. Amen?
He didn't
want to
be killed.
Right, amen. He didn't want to get killed. Nicodemus was the only secret disciple in the Bible, and you're not one of them. Amen? Well, I just glad to sit over here in the corner and just keep my peace and do my own thing and let everybody do theirs. But Jesus Christ didn't choose you to sit in the corner and do nothing. He said, I have ordained you that you may go forth and bring what?
Fruit.
How can I bring forth peaches and pears and apples and strawberries and stuff like that? I can't. What's the fruit that you're supposed to be producing? Amen? Ordain you that ye should go and bring forth fruit, and that your fruit should remain. What kind of fruit are we producing this morning, folks?
Lost souls.
Amen. Who said that? That's what we're to look for. You know what Jesus Christ told Mary over there? when he was 12 years old. And he stayed back there in the town. And they went 3 days off over here, headed back toward home. And they finally figured out that Jesus wasn't with him and went back over there and said, "Why'd you do this?" You know what he told his mama? "No, you're not.
I gotta be about my father's business.
And I must be about my father's business." Thank you, Jamie. Now, I want to see the hand that's saved by grace. Are you saved by grace? Amen. Is Jesus Christ your Savior? Keep them up there. That means God is our Father. Amen. What is our Father's business? Seeing souls saved. Jesus Christ, and I came to this world to save sinners. And that is our Father's business. Amen. And that is the fruit that we're to be. Now listen, folks. You and me. Don't get me wrong. You can't save nobody. I can't save. Dennis, you can't save nobody. I can't. But listen, blessed would be the Lord Jesus Christ. I can tell them how to get there. How can you tell them? Because I've read it, amen. I've studied it. Jesus Christ has put something down inside of each one of us, but God, if we'll just turn it loose, hallelujah, there'll be some fire kindled somewhere. Amen. Just turn loose and get ourselves out of the way, but God, why? Because Christ has chosen you to do this very thing. I'm not talking about just men. Women, y'all can talk also. Can you not talk, ladies? One is zealous. Yes, the ladies can talk. Amen. I tell you, somebody else can talk. Old Hamrick. He's not a lady, but that man can talk. Praise the Lord for it. Listen, folks, our fruit and our business and our slaughter and slip out our father's business. That's what we're to be about. Well, that's the fruit that we're looking for. Amen. Christ has chosen you. Don't think you're doing God a favor by going out there and talking to somebody. I ain't doing God a favor by going out there and testifying to somebody. Well, I went out there and told them that I was saved by grace and they need to get what I got. I think that's enough for a couple more months. That ain't it, folks. Listen, oh Lord. Has the Spirit of God got that inside of you? You ain't never been up close to the Spirit of God. Maybe you need to. Amen. When the Spirit gets inside of a person, blessed be the Lord, there's something you cannot contain the Spirit of God. It is uncontainable. You cannot restrain the Spirit of God. It better get in there, bless God. It's got to get out. Amen. I was down here cowpens the other day, and as the man asked, he said, "Trent, I want you to pray for my daughter. She's pregnant, her baby's in bad shape." I said, "Well, can we pray right now?" Don't think it's. And we got it and went to praying, and then somebody drove up on a forklift, and they stopped and shut it off. And they said, I respect you for what you're doing. Why? It's us that does the asking, but God does the answer. Amen. All we can do is ask. If God does anything, don't you go back to the one that prayed, bless God, and say, "Thank you for praying." You raise your hands toward God Almighty and say, "Lord, thank you, oh Lord God, you have given increase." It's not man got anything to do with it. Amen. Don't you respect nobody for what they try to do, bless God. It's our duty. Do we? Oh Lord, that's another good thing to thank you for. You know, the Bible has got a the master had his servants out there in the field all day, and it comes supper time. So the master's sitting there in the house, servants come in there, supper was already prepared, the master's sitting over there in his chair, and that servant just come in from plowing the field, tired, and you know he was hungry. The master said, "Servant, gird yourself and serve me, and when I'm done, you can eat." Yeah. Amen? Y'all read that?
Yeah.
The Bible says, do you think that master give praise to the servant for doing what he was commanded? The Bible says, I trow not. the servant did what he was duty to do. It's my duty to serve my master, amen? Since God has chosen us to walk with him and to bear fruit, bless God, which is trying to help lost souls find their way into the kingdom, bless God, don't give no credit to somebody.
Oh, Lord, that's a good point, too.
Thank you, Lord. You know what? I read this book, and there's some wonderful things. I can't even fathom them with my poor, pitiful mind, bless God. I can't get a grasp on a lot of things that I read in this book, bless God. But there are some magnificent things that I read in. Why don't we see that today? Amen? Why don't we see that today? Why don't we see 5,000 get saved at one time? Why don't we see 3,000 or 4,000 get fed on a few fishes and a few loaves of bread? Amen? I know why. You ever thought about that? Why don't we see fire fall from heaven as you're reading the Bible? I guarantee you, if somebody was over here talking to the Lord Jesus Christ and what they was praying for started to happen right then, amen, and people around there could see it, you know what would happen?
Look what I did.
Yeah.
No good. Amen. I told you a while ago, all we can do is ask. When something comes to pass, God gets the praise. It's not human. It's not man. It's not woman. God gets the praise. God gives the increase. God answers the prayers. It don't make no difference who's doing the praying. God answers the prayers. Amen?
Amen.
Don't think of human, Lord. Jesus Christ, he performed a miracle over there. I can't remember what it was. Probably the blind or the lame. Read the all four Gospels and you'll find it. And the people gathered around and they was going to take Jesus and set him up as King of Israel.
Yeah.
That was the people. You remember that? They was fixing the people that seen the miracle was fixing to take him and set him up and claim that he is the king. You know what Christ did? He run. Amen. He didn't want to be his king, humanly king, Daniel. He said, and the Bible says, because Christ knew what was inside of man. Amen. The pride that is ready to be built up on somebody that can do something like this, that is going to lift up the man, Christ Jesus. He wanted them to lift up God, the spirit side of it. Amen. Christ run. Listen, folks, you've been chosen of God, ain't you? Ain't you? Now, I'm not talking, we didn't privilege God, but he privileged us. Amen. He come to where you and me was. If all of us to tell the truth, we're trying to run from him. I guarantee you can't outrun him. Man, he's on a hot rod motorcycle that's, oh Lord, as fast as anything you've ever dreamed of. Remember Jonah? He tried to get away from God, didn't he?
Yeah.
Amen? Jonah?
Well, he did hit the ground. He hit the ground running.
Son, he had it shoved in the overdrive, didn't he? God said, Jonah, don't you go to Nineveh and preach?
Nope.
Jonah jumped on a ship and went the other direction toward Tarsus. Wrong! That didn't work neither, did it? Just so happened. About the right time, God says, stir in the water. Amen. Stir in the water of the sea. Praise the Lord. Everybody went to praying out to their gods. Oh, Lord, whatever, God of the sun, God of the moon, clouds, rain, thunder, lightning, whatever the God did, they all went to pray. You know where Jonah was? He down there asleep like Christ was.
Yep.
They come to him, man, why ain't you crying out to your God? He said, I'm the reason this is going on. And they got a little nervous right then. And they said, who is your God? He said, I'm an Israelite. God of heaven is my God. You know what? They just didn't get a little nervous, son. It shook their bush.
Yeah.
Amen. It shook their bush. They said, oh, Lord. Jonah said, if you throw me overboard, this thing, I'll stop. They They're trying to get that land ashore. They're doing everything, and I couldn't do it. Why? The wind was contrary to them. And they took up Jonah and they said, forgive us. Boom! Throwed him out in the ocean. Whoosh! The sea stopped. The wind stopped. The sun come out. Amen?
Yep.
You just thought they was scared to know that he was a servant of God? When it all ceased, bless God, I bet all of them said, the God of Jonah is going to be my God. Amen! The God of Jonah that stopped the sea from drinking and the wind from blowing and the thunder, bless God, that's going to be my God.
Yep.
You can't run from God. Amen. Jonah tried. I tried. You tried. But everywhere he went, there the Spirit of God was. Amen. You have not chosen me, but I have chosen you to be about my Father's business. Amen? Are you chosen today? You didn't go looking for God. I know that I needed something, but I didn't know what. Just so happened I was in the right place at the right time. No, I wasn't. God was. It don't make no difference. I've been over there in the woods, down in the gully somewhere. The day that I got saved was my day. Amen. The day that Jonah finally, you know, remember the rest of the story? The big fish come around and swallowed Jonah?
Yep.
And he said, I was in under the mountains. He said, I went down to the depths of the bottom of the sea. And he said, the weeds was up about my neck. He was inside the belly of this fish. He said, I was choking to death. And he said, Jonah said, from the belly of hell I cried. And who heard him?
God heard him.
God heard me. He said, I will. And Jonah said, I will obey. And about that time, he's just about the right place. But got that fish vomiting him out on the ground. And like Dennis said a while ago, when he hit, you ever seen a cat? If you hold up a dog over a pool of water, what happens? He ain't touching the water. He just paddling just to get ready. That's the way Jonah was. Bless God, when that fish hit him, bless God, he's just like that dog, son. He had her in the gallop mode. When he finally touched the ground, bless God, he shoved it in the overdrive, and he went to Nineveh. In a day's time, he went 3 days' journey. Glory to God! I'm glad I'm saved by grace. I tell you what, folks, if you're saved by grace, there's something inside of you. You know what Paul tells Timothy? Stir up the gift of God which is in you. Amen.
Yep.
He said, which was in your grandmother Lois and your mother Judas also. And he said, I'm also persuaded of you. If you've got the gift in there, bless God, how do you stir it up? Lord, I need your help today. That's what Brian said when he got on the hall. Brian said, the Lord was right there beside me, and he said, I can hear him. Amen? You may have got a word on your heart.
I'm glad I got to be here.
Me too. To have a vision here.
Me too.
That's all I got, folks. Unless you got something else on your heart, that'll be it. You've been chosen of God. We didn't make the choice. Jesus Christ made the choice. And our Father's business is to help people, to love one another, to be compassionate, suck that pride up, spit it out. Y'all remember, read the book of Isaiah chapter 6. Dennis, come, you ain't gonna eat with us? You got to go. Be careful. Remember the over there in the book of Isaiah, I believe it's chapter 6. Read it, you'll find it. And the Lord asked this question. Who will go for us?
Yep.
Amen?
He said, I'll go.
Isaiah stood up. I'll go, Lord, send me.
Yep.
That's what we agreed to when the Lord chose us and we accepted His invitation, bless God. Lord, I'll go. Send me. Amen. Same thing for us. Who wants to ask the blessing on the... Wait a minute. Does anybody need anything of the Lord? There's food out here by the gongs. Thank you, Chris.
Sorry.
Marianne got 4 or 5 dishes out there. Miss Amrit got dishes. Nancy got dishes. Jennifer, what'd you make, Melody?
Nothing.
She got clean up from us.
Oh, well, that's good enough. You need anything, folks? Stir that gift up down inside of there. Well, I don't know how. I know the one that's got the stick. Amen? Brian, you know the one that got the stick? He can stir it there like a puddle. You ever seen a puddle of lard being stirred? You can get it started and that thing will stir for 20 minutes on its own. Amen?
Yep.
Anybody ever seen that rendered? Somebody rendering lard?
You yep.
Get that thing to stirring? Step back and that thing will still be stirring after a yep. long time. It'll still be moving around and around. Lord, when the Spirit of God gets stirred down in here, oh, Lord, it'll stir for a while. Amen? Brian, bless the food and dismiss us, please.
Yeah, Lord, thank you for the service we had here today. Thank you for letting the camp